Hello. There we go. Do I sound robotic? Because I left the AC on. There we go. Hopefully that's better. How's it going? What's it going? How's life? Trying to get everything sorted. I thought about I don't know, streaming me doing some solder stuff. Didn't feel like it. Didn't feel like it going through it. The outlets was like the biggest problem. But yeah, before I go to bed, I have to solder this 12 volt cord for my aunt. It's just, yeah, she said it was heating up, and you know, there's a giant hunk of electrical tape there, and I'm like, I wonder what. It's all just like kind of twisted together in there, but frays are flowing freely, doing their own thing. Yeah. Yeah, I planned on streaming yesterday, but appointments and things and life got in the way. The fifth, I have another appointment. Hopefully, I'll be getting these wisdom teeth out eventually. That would be nice. I'm kind of past due a little bit. I'm surprised, you know, they're not rotting the rest of my teeth out, so that's good. So yeah, that was good news to hear, at least, that I'm not gonna lose my smile at the very least, so. Yeah. But it did crack one, like over here. That was bad news. It was because it tried to come forward or something. But that one was already chipped, I believe, like from a long time ago. Being stupid. Pretty sure I bit like a beer cap or something. And it just chipped that one way back there. So it was happening with that one either way. But it's still there, still causing issues, so it's gotta go. Anyway, that's all that's happening with me, really. I bought a mouse pad because I'm still like scooting my mouse across the desk. Cool. You're set. Nice and chill. Just little. Puzzly games, and hanging out. Now I'm trying to decide if I want to use a controller or if I actually want to use my mouse. My controller works. That's good news. Let's check out some graphic settings. There is. Oh, here we go. Ultra high, ultra, ultra. That should be fine. Let's freaking go! Raw abilities recharge when taking damage. Aggressive. Yeah, we'll go spirit guide. That's what we do. I'm not fiddling around with easy. So there's you might notice a slight hiss, which I thought was my microphone, but no, it's the it's the dang background. Thanks. It's good, unique wooden sort honor the dead, placed in sacred shrines as mass gradually return to dust, symbolizing the spirit's peaceful journey to the next life. Not all spirits can travel this path alone. Struggling with tragedies of their past, they linger and become dangerous. Masters called upon to help these trapped and violent manifestations are known as spirit guides. I barely got through that. And it's not even showing on OBS. So hold on. Thank goodness it pauses or whatever it does. What in the ass? Okay, then. Just do game capture. It might be because it's in full screen, so we'll try this. Yeah. And we're good. It's nice and sized, all pretty. Cool. Freaking cool. In the olden days, I would have never noticed something like that. That's not too dark, is it? It's too dark for you guys. Game. Graphics. It's graphics. Target FPS. Where is it now? Where's the. Will I never be able to set the brightness again? What a terrible thing. I mean, that could just be this monitor for me. I don't know. The whole monitor is like kind of darker than the other one. It's weird. It's a weird thing, and I hope it's not like too bad for you guys. This is what I should do. Yes, please. Please take me to the link. Yes, please. Please do. Why do I do this to myself? Como what? Am I looking at a VOD here? There we go. For some reason, it started streaming way back at the beginning. Okay, yeah, it's just that monitor. It's still a little bit darker on here than what I would have hoped, but. Go away, go away, go away, go away, go away. Get out of here. I will never do that again. God. It's always something. Accessibility, maybe? I doubt it. I doubt there's no way. No. Who doesn't give you that, you can change this later in the settings scenario. What a trooper. Although I did notice there was like clicking noises the whole last time I was like playing it half the time, so. Okay, I'm going to move this. And hopefully that helps. I just feel like there's something up there. And I finally make it. Oh. Alright. Let's test ourselves. Agile, nimble. So, what do I do with these? They light up. What? Some sort of photo mode. All right, let's get out of this dumb gin, please. She's going that way, but I want to go this way because I want to explore everything. But yeah, this game looked really pretty, at least from the cutscenes that I saw on Epic, and it took forever. Well, not forever, really, for it to go on sale. It went on sale a couple times. Took a lot less time than another game company put things on sale. Okie dokie. Dang, I'm good. Question mark. I'm just wondering, like. Okay, I can't hop out of there. Why all the excess pathways? Ninja.
Why have you come?
Oh, I know that voice. Suffering here,
spirit. Do you need help?
You know nothing of suffering.
Oh God, why can't I think of his name? Ooh. Okay. How do I? Okay. Right click. So, gotcha. At least it won't screw me up for Elden Ring. Simple enough. Just trying to find some decent combos if there are any. Oops. I'm controlling it with the mouse. I was gonna see. Can't see the audio output. Oh, that's hot. At least at its peak. That's probably okay though, because I turned everything up after that last stream, so it wasn't like unwatchable, but it was oddly quiet, and the output was just me. I must have played a loud game before I stopped last time, and I don't know. The knob on the actual microphone, not the gain settings, was what was kind of screwing it up voice wise. There we go. Get you some. Get you some Orbeez lights. Oh, okay, over here. Easy enough. I wouldn't mind a bit of backstory, but I think it's coming. Oh, I see. There we go. Yeah, let's freaking go. Let's fucking do it, yeah. What am I hearing? Oh my god, I'm hearing the stream that I closed out of, but it's still running. Stop it. I just swiped down the notification button and hit the stop button. Genius. I was a heck of a stutter there. Ultra graphics. Obamaphone Pro Max 5G. Oh, okay. A little bit of frame issues. Just a touch. It's probably because I'm streaming and doing dumb stuff. I hear people. I'm not alone.
I saw him here somewhere. Where did he go?
Oh my god, you know what? This is off topic. I thought about playing Golem just because of how terrible it is. Or at least everyone says it. I mean, I've seen a couple clips and it's just awful. Like, I thought people were exaggerating. I thought people were finally becoming way too jaded. I was like, they were like, oh, this is taking us back. Oh, okay. This is taking us back to the Xbox 360 graphics days and stuff. I was like, well, that's not so bad, is it? You know, I mean, they're still making indie games and stuff. If the world's big enough, sometimes you might need to pinch the graphics down a little bit, but this is so gross. The things I saw, I can tell you some stories. It's gross. Made me wince. It made me. It gave me the squeams. I didn't have the squeams before. Yeah, come on. I mean. Oh, here we go. So we're collecting, little boy. Hopefully the fan's not over there. It's probably fine. It's probably okay.
Hi. Aww. It's all right. What happened here, little guy?
I saw those frames. They fell on the floor somewhere over here. Oh yeah, I already figured that much out, baby. I might twerk this down a little bit. Yeah, twerk on it. Invisible rod. Yeah, motion blur is never something you need up very high, you know? It's never something I would pick in general. Shadows, that's hit or miss. That could be detrimental. I can make or break something. I think for the first time ever, motion blur almost did it dirty. I think it'd be alright. Yeah, like I said, mine is hop, skip, and a jump away from being a potato as well. But we're getting there.
There she is. Run.
Oh. They're not real people. They're rot. I'll find you. When it mentioned something called rot, I was picturing the forest being destroyed or something. Yeah, I'm just gonna cheese it. I'm just gonna do this everywhere. Says drop frame zero, but I don't trust it. I don't believe it. Simple enough. Lots of directions to take here. Referring for Rain, got this for his PlayStation. He said it was good. And I was like, "Dang, man! I wanted to play this. Can't believe you played it already." He's now Cruel Squirrel. Apparently. Possible soon to be bike. Sort of a skateboard kind of BMX video or something, maybe. If he's feeling up for it. I'll probably do the editing work for it. He's into doing BMX and to get out more, you know. He's been getting back into it. So I'm all for that. And we filmed a couple of clips. Just, I don't know how much of that will get used because it was like an old, dirty like bench that was already bending and rotting. It was not very good. There was a couple other things. Yeah, he was actually able to nail the 180 pretty well. Like, he 180s, and then he tailspins back to the original position. Oh, I lost my train of thought. That's what it was called for a second there. Well, there's one. Okay, so now we're learning. Dance. Oh. Yeah, I bet my son would love this. It's probably something he should play. Yeah, give him kiss. That's cute. We're just full of adorable things this week. I'm gonna throw up from the diabetes. It's a dick thing to say that. It is cute though. Oh, treasures. Do I actually unlock things? Oh, one of these guys. I thought it was an actual treasure. Not this trash. Oh, here we go. I have one raw action available. One! Press X to send a raw onto objects in the environment. Okay. There's not a reason that people aren't that I haven't seen like many people stream this. I think I've seen a couple of people do it. I'm just hoping there's not a very specific reason or something like this music. Because it sounds good. Because I got that stuff turned up right now. Like a fool. I'm playing with the buttons now. So that's what I'm supposed to do right there, basically. All right, unlocks new areas. Nice. And okay, the children are not have not died or become the forest. Good things. Oh man, yeah. Why couldn't we exist in a world like this, right? Like, I would have loved to have been born as like a forest druid. That would be amazing. Oh no, I'm starving. Well, guess what? Here's a bunch of apples. What a life. I just want to check down here real quick. I'm a big secrets guy. Nothing. Unless it's behind the waterfall. No, that's not. What are you doing up there? Gotta jump across ledges, okay. Oh, whoops. All right. Okay, so I'm looking for white sticky goop when I need to go all Assassin's Creed on this piece. This looks like a boss area. Yeah, I just dropped into something. Whoa! How insanely unexpected! Who could have guessed? Attack enemies to build courage in combat, spend courage to perform on it. Okay, we got this. Can form in worlds. Collect courage drops with your paws or touch them to build up courage faster. Okay. Ow! Broad action available. They can destroy dead zone hearts. Okay. Hold LT to aim. Press X to bind enemies. What would that do? Go get him. Go get him. Yeah, I'm just gonna clear up the forest. Why does nose always itch during the fights, man? Gross. I gotta dodge better. This is an everlasting fight here, man. Only the quick moves. That's what I'm about. Oh, wait. Doi. What am I doing? I was like, why isn't it? Maybe it just takes a few, but no, it's just me. I forgot to do the thing. That's right. No, I just extended the fight because I'm awesome. I needed more fight. It wasn't enough fight. I needed more. LT and pressing X. Okay. I don't know where I'm going with this yet. I barely looked around. So please. Bear with me for a second. Bear with me, little rock boys. Why was that? Excusez-moi. is that just a tutorial thing? Like, yeah, just move it here because tutorial, and that's fine. Or am I supposed to move it here? Yeah, probably. I'm an idiot. There you go. Move it there. Such an interesting spot for it to be nothing. No. There we go. There we go. I could leap across there, but what was back here? Oh.
Can you pick that up?
Okay, it gave me a little bit of points. Don't know what that is, but I'm sure we'll find out here in a bit. Oh boy.
Can you move that for me?
Moving here. I actually don't know. Oh, just a shortcut or something? Okay. The general vibe. Reminds me of Windbound. I might play that again on my own time. Windbound, because I remember I think I had it for GOG when I played it on stream, and recently also got it for Steam and the Nintendo Switch. Because it was like $2 on both of those platforms. And usually my son likes to play the things that I'm playing, so when I replayed it, I wanted to have it ready, but I don't think that'll be the case this time, of course, because I preemptively got ready for that.
You sense the power that flows through this land, but you do not fully understand
yet. I can't remember this guy's name. He was in Bullet Train. The guy who fought White Death at the end.
All that remain here.
This land can be healed, but you can't.
If it's not him, it sounds like him. Like dead on.
You are the one who does not belong. I will never abandon my people.
Nice. Okay, good to know. I'll be using dodge more than shield, probably. Unless it becomes, like, detrimental.
I
Oh, you about dead, dude. It's over for you. Oh, God. Oh. There we go. She got a bit dirty. Use the rock. Like, what is his people? He won't abandon his people. What is his people? Just rot things? Groot? Getting killed by Groot? That's his people. I don't think he's probably not evil. He's probably just misunderstood, you know?
You can come out. It's safe now.
Look, Saya, she cleared away the poison. The little guys can eat it.
I thought they were the little things, like just transformed into like people or something.
My name's Kana. What are you two doing out here, alone in the forest?
Don't worry about us. We've been here a long time and take care of ourselves.
I can see that. You both look very strong. Do you know who that spirit was, with the horned mask?
We don't know, but when he shows up, the gross poison grows stronger.
Hey, what are you doing here in the forest?
I'm searching for the sacred mountain shrine. Can you take me there?
If you want to get to the mountain shrine, you have to help us with something first.
Oh no. I'm already on a quest.
Trapped deep in the forest. We need you to help him.
Great idea, Saya. That'll be easy for her.
Did you help us free Taro and we'll take you to the mountain shrine.
Woohoo!
Come on. Our village is this way.
Our village is this way. Yeah, I plan on playing this on stream. To the extent that it can be, as well as Tunic. I want to replay that. I played it once and I beat the boss way too early. It didn't unlock everything. This time I would like to go through and get all the items, because there is like a new game plus where you keep some of your items and kind of go through it again, so I would like to explore that. But you know, I don't know if I'll do new game plus on stream of either of these. I might, or at least start them out just to see what's going on, but I do want to see what's in new game plus of Tunic, and I did want to explore the rest of it because a lot of the concepts in that game are really cool. I really love the sort of the game book or whatever it is that you begin to understand as you go through and solve the little puzzles within it. I just love that. And I like that there's incentive to do it, but it's not necessarily required. It's always a plus. Okay. Yeah, I gotta start streaming when people are awake, I think. Might be a good plan. Good starting plan for stream. To get it around, you know. Though, like, the thing is, yeah, my son's usually awake during the day, and, yeah, he would be all over trying to, oh, nice, trying to goof it up or click buttons or something. He does that when playing games sometimes. Might be entertaining, but wouldn't want him to click the wrong thing, you know? Plus, I don't know the guidelines for that sort of thing. Like, you know, would I then have to mark my vods with, you know, that he would appear in as, like, you know, kid video or something, you know, and then what? I have to, you know, must keep up with a certain candor and things. It's just too much to think about, you know. They have too many policies. that's the issue. I can't just, you know, I could exist, do whatever I want. I really don't care, but, you know, I try to keep it afloat, I guess. Oh, yay. I don't know. I'm rambling. Yeah, I mean, at night it's just quieter. Like, it's not just that either. It's like everything that goes on during the day. You know, I have the school calling about one thing or another. And, oh, basketball's been changed from this date to this date. And all this good stuff. And it's not that that would get in the way of anything, it's just that, it's just the constant phone calls and everything, basically. And everything, people that occasionally knock at the door on a rare occasion during the day. Just really rather not, you know, I mean, that's why I like playing video games at night. I think that's why a lot of people do. It's, you know, the only real time that you can sit and not have to worry about something potentially obstructing your day. I think that's why a lot of us, like, get caught up staying up at night and stuff like that. That's why I do, at least, for the most part. I fixed my schedule so many times, and I just continue to screw it up because I want a couple hours to just chill. All right. Strike from a distance. A rock hammer. Pretty cool. But what are these? While sprinting, press RB to perform a quick sweeping attack. Okay. Press RB after parrying to perform spinning. So I'd have to parry. I hate having to parry. Oh my god. It's not bad in most games. You know, I've not had like an awful experience with it lately. It was like when the parry ability first became a thing in video games. Like, you know, it was just terrible. It was awful then. It's not awful anymore. So I guess I'm doing the run. It's the only thing I can afford, so. Okay. That's cool. Oh, you won't let me see charms yet. Won't really let me see the map either. Okay, here we go. Fresh. Okay, so we're going east then. Towards a locked door. Oh, yeah. Is that a charm? A rot hat? Okay. It's a pot. You can decorate the rots. Adorable. A shop? A rot shop? Party hat, cake hat, pot hat. We got the pot hat. Now I'm wondering if, is there reason to get more than one? Or is this where they unlock? Or do I not get them because I will unlock them? Because I see ones on these. Nothing's on this. I just purchased one. Okay. Yeah, so they unlock here. I already have these, apparently. how that works. Golden. Yeah, let's do party. Stick a cake on one. I have no idea. One will be gold, I guess. Oh, she has different outfits. That's cool. Alright, I'll save up for that. Ooh, shadow. I don't know, I kind of like the original better. Yeah, those Ugg boots. Yeah. Yeah, Ugg boots just look better. I like the gloves on the shadow, but other than that, the rest of it just looks better. Deluxe! Bruh. No, the OG's fine. We'll take the deluxe. Triple deluxe. Double bacon, triple whopper. Hook me up. Get me in here.
Is Tara this way? The barrier's blocking the path.
Maybe Sanju can help. He's usually at the mess. You'll know when you see the sacred tree.
Oh. Okay, so where's that then? North. Wait. Okay, yeah. Alright, we're heading north. That's gross. Oh, okay. We did something.
The rot seem quite fond of you.
God, it makes me want to camp or go out in the woods. Just relax.
Something tells me you did not come to our village looking for forest creatures.
Hello, spirit. I seek passage to the sacred mountain shrine.
Our village is bound to the shrine's energy, but that power faded long ago. Trapped spirits linger here, tangled in the tragedies of our past. You must help these spirits if you wish to reach the mountain shrine.
On my way, I met two children. They asked me to help free a boy named Taro.
I'm not surprised that Benny and Saya found you. They are clever children and would do anything for their brother. We have always crafted wooden masks to honor those who have passed on. Placed here, the masks slowly turn to dust, aiding the spirit's journey into the next life.
My father was a spirit guide. Our traditions are different, but he helped many spirits pass from this life to the next.
So you know what happens to spirits unable to move on. Take Taro's mask. It is bound to his spirit and will help you fulfill your promise to the children. Look after Benny and Saya. Their brother's fate.
Oh, you can wear them. A open spirit barrier reveal objects of importance in the environment. Thank you. I don't know why my throat's tickling. Dudes get me sick. Hope not. I hope not. Yeah. What are they gonna do with that? Oh, okay. Misstep in this and be okay. I feel like I can't. Yeah, I'm dead. Oh yeah, they're just fine though. They're all good. Ah, I see. Okay. Yeah, but I won't be able to do that until I get another... somebody else's spirit mask. Is that saying? Nothing. I thought it said tag. Alright. It's in here then. It's not yet. Adorbs. Little clovers in the hair. How did I just walk right past that chest? Is this open? Oh, it does. Okay. I'm gonna have to be more careful. Warp. Okay. Cool. Not doing that right now, though. Much fruit. Well, if it makes them happy. We break it. Nah, this seems pretty, for the most part, pretty polished. I don't think I'm breaking anything right now, at least. That's what I just did. Dude, I want to make a burger. I'm hungry. How do I do this to myself? Egg burger. Egg burger with cheddar cheese. That's what I'm saying, bro. Egg burger. all I can think about. Saying, what are we doing with that? Oh, we're moving it here or something. So what are we doing with this? Sure about that one. It's a little secret, I don't know what's going on with. Couple chests. Few chests. Cursed chest. Heavy enemies requires heavy hits. Not too bad. Where even am I right now? Like right back where I was. That's me in a nutshell, going in circles. Actually, but oh yeah, that's right. When you unlock it, you can just buy it though. All right, never mind then. Upgrades though. Oh, that's a different currency. Okay. Yeah, we're not doing anything. I guess that means we can buy more stuff at some point. I didn't want to buy stuff with upgrade money, you know? It's not smart moves. Ah, here we go. Wasn't this where the chest was? Now it must have been somewhere else. Can't get in there though. There's that chest. I can't hit that, that stone, though. Come around here. I was trying to see if one way might be easier to jump than the other. Yeah, you definitely want to get as much distance as you can. I don't know if I'd want to do this. Probably not smart to do. Yeah, we'll wait until we can unlock it. It's probably just gems or something anyway. Purify special flowers to restore our health. Okay. I think we're alright though, for now. Oh, no, no, we're not alright. God, it's like the exact same controls as Elden Ring. Alright, does it want me to use this just to be tutorialized? I mean, I'm fine with that, but it'd just be nice to know, you know? Okay, apparently it wasn't required. I thought I had to hit every single one of those health points for like some sort of tutorial. Temporarily restore the rock to their original form. And clear corruption. Oh. Oh, I see.
Whoa, look what happened to the rod. He's so cute. Look at him go. Does he know any tricks, Kana?
Oh. And off they goes. Some corruption in the bridge over here. Wasn't entirely sure if they could fix that or not, but it appears so. Maybe. No, I guess not. Because now, like, there's a corruption in a certain area. Tricked me. Made me believe in myself. And then he stole it all. He stole everything from me. There we go.
Over here, Kena. There's something in the ground.
I bet a forest here can grow here.
No? I don't get it.
Go get it.
Oh, get in the bucket. All right.
Hey, the little rock guys did it. They made another one.
So for that other flower, I have to find a bucket, maybe, with that stuff, whatever that stuff is. Must be him. Oh, maybe not. It's just a nice lad. I can jump up here. I guess I was supposed to come up here anyway, by the looks of it. Let's go. What is that? They spawn in front. Ah, I see. Well, no, that's a health plant, isn't it? I'm not sure if I was supposed to do something with that or just attack enemies with it. I'm hoping I'm supposed to do something specific. Oh, jeez. Release, release. Stop looking at them, I'm trying to heal. Okay. That wasn't very cool of you. I like it. Which way am I supposed to go? Because I want to explore. Oh, okay. Oh, whoops. A little bow. Ooh, dark. Spooky time for a memory. Thank you. now.
Taro!
What happened? What did you see when you put on Taro's mask?
Taro is here, but he's forgotten who he is. We need to find 3 relics to help him remember.
The forest is huge. How do we know where to look? Maybe Mr. Russo can help us. His house is up that way.
I was thinking like a huge like boss fight was coming just now. Evil Taro. His house is just up there. About a day's journey. Scale the dang mountains. Oh. There you go, there's some fruit boys. Well, I don't know. Been a pretty quiet night. It's 3 a.m. Maybe I could make this one a short one. Oh god, I thought I was dead, and then staring at PN leaves. Oh god. That's how they did it. That's the secret. What the heck? Yeah, that's just the inner, like the inner cone. A lot of, everyone does that. But it's just funny. There you go. Have some more fruit. Why the block clue thing again? Oh. Is there a way to get those? Probably need some sort of blast ability or sky attack of some kind. Oh, maybe? No. Nope, it's gotta be something like this. Nice little warp area. I don't know if I have to do that to, like, activate it, or if I just have to walk by the thing. I'm just doing it just in case. Wow. Like, semi-linear, but a lot more open than I anticipated, at least in this sort of area. Really cool. I like that. Up the log there, I think. Yeah, it's 3 a.m. and I'm thinking about a burger. Seriously. Like, I'm gonna go downstairs, I'm gonna wash a pan. So I've been using that pan constantly. I was at my grandma's at one point, and I discovered that she has a spatula that is specifically for her cookies. And now I'd be frightened to, like, cook anything in her house, like, you know, be being afraid of using the wrong thing. Me, I use one spatula until it looks disgusting. Like, until it's, like, bubbly. And it's garbage or something, you know. Until it's basically useless. Or at least it looks bad enough that I want to replace it. Most times I use a spatula until I just move and lose that spatula. If I'm being entirely honest. Yeah, I use the same pan for everything. I just use the one pot and the one pan and never use anything else. Not often. There's sometimes, like, I'll use the bigger pot if I'm making a lot of pasta salad or something. But when, like, I'm making spaghetti, it's usually just me and Bradley, so. Me and little turtle souples. We just, that was a little crazy. He just made an appearance and disappeared. Yeah, so we just, we only need the small pot to make, well, the, like, a, it's like a medium-sized, like, pot to make a spaghetti for both of us. I gotta dodge more. I don't know why I'm not dodging as much. Extra uh-oh, please unlock. Oh, nope, yep, no dodge there. I didn't expect him to just come up with a club like a savage and just annihilate me like that. I expected some sort of intricate attack to wait and watch out for. This is gonna screw me up. It's really gonna screw me up in terms of Elden Ring. Like, I might stream that one day, like, once I actually have it on my own account and I'm not playing on somebody else's. But yeah, it's a family member, so. Why am I stuck? Like, I couldn't look around. That was really weird. But it's not as hard as I anticipated. It's not as bad as Dark Souls, by any means. So, I don't know how entertaining it would be, because I didn't die to the werewolf kick and just beat him. I didn't die, I died twice to the watchdog, I believe in. Yeah, I expected the savage attack this time, but. Oh my god, dude. Absolute savagery. Okay, man, and the aim on this. Like when you're aiming for stuff, specifically. Not always on point. Ah, come on, get up, get up. There we go. I think we got it. Yeah, we did. No more health. God, why does... What the heck, man? Man. Nah, it's the only way I can defeat those things. They're like ape versions of those creatures. Are those his people? Maybe? I would not abandon my people. Oh my god. Hey Meg, how's it going? Thanks for the follow. How's your 3 a.m. going? Mine's fantastic. Oh, okay. That jingling is in the game. It is not in my bedroom, thank goodness.
One of Tara's memories. I should see where it leads me.
Anyways, before I was like being decimated in battle, we were talking about pants. Riveting, I know. Yeah, I probably have the best pant I've had ever. I got this one from someone for free, so that's amazing. Like, I barely have to put oil on the dang thing, and it just, nothing sticks. At least yet. Maybe over time. Oh, but yeah, I'm happy to finally be back. Can't wait until we go grocery shopping, but first we have to like do this. Okay, we're gonna use the mask. Can I do that first? I want to do that first. We gotta do this thing where we get the schooling set up from here. On the exact same day I was planning on getting groceries once we get paid. Oh, okay. It's like, where's the corruption? Corruption here too, so we're gonna need that. We're gonna need it. Come on. Beautiful. Yeah. Oh, geez. All right. I didn't anticipate that. Nice. Did we, sudden stop in the music? Did we get enough for some skills? Yeah, I didn't even know that parrying was a thing. Activate the shield at the right moment to parry enemies. Okay. I think I'm gonna grab this. Grab one more thing. Let's do the parry. We'll see if we can get parrying a shot here. But a big thing about that is learning the enemy's moves, which, I mean, thankfully they're the same enemies basically over and over.
Let's keep going.
Okay, so I'm guessing I just have to walk past that because it just kind of did its thing. Sec here. Oh, okay. Set up. Check. You probably heard Discord. Yes. Oh, there we go. Oh God, oh God, no, don't do it to me. No! Oh. I didn't expect it to kill me. Oh, you have to sprint. Oh my God. I did not realize. Where am I right now? Oh God. That's so weird. Okay. Oh, all right. So there's got to be somewhere else that I'm missing. Is it just down there? Because this rock just doesn't look like one that's supposed to be stood on. Side here. Reminds me of when I was streaming Horizon Zero Dawn a little bit. I wanted to finish that on stream, but man, that thing ate up so much of my Junker CPU. Ran relatively fine. It just ran hot. It was a little bit questionable about it. Easy. If I should go down there. Yeah, it doesn't look like there's anything down there. I'll probably miss things along the way. I'm rushing more than I normally would. What is that? I want it, please. Can I has? Can I send them in there? Okay, I don't know what that is, but I don't want to leave without it. I see. Spirit man. And belong to a villager. Return it to their house in the village. Location's marked on a map. Okay. Well, hopefully that was worthwhile. Nice backflip. Whoops. I pushed B when I should have pushed A. Genius. Okay. Now we're just not grabbing ledges. That's fine. That's cool. You can do that if you like. Am I too tired? Like, cause I, is that not like an automated thing that they usually have? Like, to grab ledge when you drop, not just deliberately drop in between two grabbable ledges. It could be user error, but I don't know. That was a little weird. Yeah. Scale building. The game. It's joking. All right. Yeah, there she is.
The bridge is broken. Maybe the rock can help.
Nope. Looks like you're out of luck there, bud. No. Dang it. You figured it out.
Hurry. I don't think they can hold it for long.
You know what? You hurry. I'm going this way. I want to see what's over here. A cursed chest.
Go get it.
Yeah, there you go. It's a little fruit for you. Oh no. Who could have anticipated that it was cursed? Oh, okay. What? One shot. Dang, bro. One shot by the twig. You just came up and Ken Griffey'd my face. Okay. I'll be sure to dodge everyone because somehow I had no health. Hey, Breadmine, how you doing? Yeah, it's been a hot minute. I'm doing all right. How are you doing? I'm making it. I'm craving a burger, but other than that, I'm holding it together. Oh my god, why do I have so little health? What could I have possibly done? I have full health. If that is how. I have no idea what that is. I don't know what's health in this game. It's just relative. Yeah, got moved in. Got the internet going. Everything's going. Already created more stressors than I should be handling. But that's fine. Doing kind of all right. Yeah, that's about it. That's all you can do. Why does my health immediately go down? Is this like a challenge to... My buddy fell off the edge. Haha. Get out of here, dude. I'm not allowed to take one hit. Okay. I did it. Jeez. Oh yeah, I missed this. A bird's nest hat, not worth it. It's fun. They're mostly collectibles. Oh, and class. I can't even imagine to be in your shoes. They would yell at me for using a calculator. All right. I got my phones taken away so many times. I don't think they can hold it. And they were flip phones. Like, how much could we have really done with them? But they got taken away so much. Why lose it? Wouldn't mind finding a way to heal up.
Is powerful. There must be a relic nearby. I need to find another way around.
Why the calculator? I don't know. They would just get mad. And be like, you're not always going to have a calculator in your pocket. Yeah, no, just a supercomputer. No big deal. Certainly not a calculator. Oh god, this thing's going to kill me. He's a man. Yeah, I didn't mind learning like math that mattered. Even things like the formulas for area, like pi radius squared, and learning how to figure out diameter and all that. Because I've seen like at least examples of scenarios in which those would be useful, but there would always be like these certain types of math that would drive me insane. Yeah, all the math is letters, and we just pull some random one out of nowhere to, you know, like I get the, you know, 3 plus y equals 6. Okay, yeah, that makes sense. Solve for y, fine. But, yeah, they'd be like y plus x equals z, and they would just pull random numbers out of nowhere. I have no idea what that was, but it drove me insane. It's like, how do you get that? And they would never answer me as to how they got that number to begin with to solve the problem. I'm like, well, then prepare for my answer to always be wrong, because I have no idea what you're doing. Take this! Where's... is there an open flower yet? Yes. God. There's always itches on the battles. When it's all heated. I don't know where I'm moving this. Here? Seems to be it. Nice. Nice. So nice. Yeah, I plan on streaming a bit more again, getting back into it. I'm probably gonna start, you know, probably gonna do this and Tunic. It's a couple of starter streams that I'll probably enjoy. I beat Tunic before, but I beat the boss before I got everything, so I would kind of like to learn the majority of the puzzles at least, because I really enjoyed the puzzles and how they worked. Slowly reading the game book over time. Oh my god, I just got done fighting. This is the big boy. You can feel it. Get the nose itch now before. Okay. Papa. Oh, okay. Okay, so I think he's just gonna make enemies until I can stop him with my little guys. Like that. Ooh. Big oofs, man. Pepe peed a little bit, thinking I was gonna die. I'm sorry, give me more of these. Need them. Is serious. This is what's nuts. Like, in order to heal yourself, you need to hurt enemies to use those creatures. It's like, continue attacking enemies so that you can heal yourself. Oh my god. Hopefully you don't die in the process. I was hoping I could get it. Yeah, I figured that was gonna happen. That sucks. Yeah, it sucks you can't heal yourself unless you kill so many enemies so that your little dudes are like courageous enough to go get a flower and heal you. Yeah, it's okay. You'll be dead and cowards. How's that sound? It's challenging. Not bad though. I like it. Oh, it was a. I didn't know that by default they just explode. And just avoid them. Okay, I know when he attacks now, so I can at least avoid him. God, my clicking is like right next to the microphone, probably. Getting intense! Where is he? There he is. Nice. Wrecked. Right in that new spot. Oh god.
Uh-huh. You made it. I think we found Mr. Russo.
Oh yeah.
This way.
At least it's the weekend, man. At least it's the weekend. Tomorrow, I'm going to my cousin's to have breakfast for dinner.
Can you pick that up?
It's a thing he's done a couple times. Where we just annihilate ourselves on sausage and egg and... I think he made pancakes and stuff last time too, but I didn't mess with that. And Sunday I should have a delivery coming in. I'll finally have a mouse pad again. I lost Swagword mouse pad. I sent my computer and all my computer stuff to my mom's while I was waiting to get moved in. And I'm guessing it's there somewhere, just lost in her house. Swagward. He had like this hat on. He was like in front of a Nike shoe, sipping tea, looking just fresh. It's just... The fit was insane on Swagward. Yeah, I just got a black mouse pad this time. Just one of the big ones.
Hey, Mr. Russo, we've been looking for you.
And they got like those silicone baggies.
She's here to help Taro.
Wahoo!
The power of the mountain shrine is connected to everything in this forest. The trees here grew strong, drawing on its energy.
I was wondering if I could recognize this voice actor as well.
But like all things, the mountain shrine follows a natural cycle.
Yeah, they have these silicone baggy things that you can buy now for, it's like 15, 20 bucks for like two of them. And you gotta wash them and stuff. I'm like, no, dude, I can't. I'm just gonna get sandwich bags. But for $6, they had like 16 of these like over bowl lid things that like stretch around your bowl, whatever. They probably snap after a while, I don't know, but I'll take a risk, 16 for $6 over two of those stupid Ziploc bags.
You can still help Taro, Russo.
Ridiculous. I don't know.
There's
I can't
really
do it.
Covered by the corruption at your house.
There's inflation, and then there's just insanity.
That weapon you carry, I sense it holds a deeper power.
I'm just happy eggs are back down. I'm eating eggs again sometimes, a little bit. I just quit with eggs.
He must have been a great
soldier. And then I realized how much I used it for like cookies and biscuits and it's
I
like,
made
crap, man.
Against the corruption, but I can teach you a new way to fight it back.
You can't tell I'm hungry. I'm midnight peckish. It's like 3:30 in the morning and I want to eat food for no reason.
A spirit guide staff is no different. Ground yourself. Feel the energy of the mountain. Draw on its power.
Nice. I saw there were projectiles in this. I'm really glad that they don't. It's not like too late in the game when it happens.
Try using your bow on these targets. When you are finished, feel free to practice at the other stations I've set up.
Okay, how do I use my bow? LT to aim. Okay, simple enough. This is a part I would want to use mouse and keyboard for, probably. Okay. Let me see. Let me give her a test spin. Nope, that is not. Oh my god. Why does it seem so much faster with a... Okay. Okay, it's about the same. Something in me was like, dude, this is way faster. Oh, okay. So you hold shift for keyboard. I mean, yeah, keyboard and mouse just does look smoother. The only thing, though, is I would not want my dodge to be controlled. I could handle playing this on a keyboard and mouse. It's just, yeah, that's just the main thing. I'll set that up for next time, most likely.
Can you pick that up?
Yeah, I mean, that seems like a good place to stop. Nice couple hour stream. I got stuff to do tomorrow, so as always. But it is the weekend. As long as I'm not too destroyed from breakfast for dinner, I should be streaming again tomorrow. Tunic, I think, is what will be tomorrow. I want to try to mix it up a little bit, but not too much, because in the past, I have, like, overdone it, like, too many games all at once, and it gets crazy. But, I think two, like, one every other day can work out. Because I've also got games I'm playing personally, like Tears of the Kingdom and stuff like that. Not, yeah, I have no way. I don't have a capture card or anything, and I'm not spending $200 on one either, so there's just no way to stream that. Plus, with, you know, what they did to that one guy who was, like, modding and stuff, like, that's just messed up. I'm not even gonna chance it at this point with them, you know, with that one company, you know. I'm just not doing it with Tears of the Kingdom, which is unfortunate, but... Yeah. Anyway. Yeah, so I think Tunic tomorrow, I believe, unless I'm really feeling this, but I'm pretty sure, you know, I'll swap over to Tunic and I'll just go back and forth. Anyways, thanks for hanging out. I appreciate those of you that were here. Make for the follow if you are a real human being and not a follow bot. And Brett for popping in, appreciate it. Enjoy school, class. Yeah, I did, like, I did a trade school. It was, like, paid for through, my public school, so it wasn't bad. You know, like, a couple years of, electronics or whatever. But I've been thinking about taking up something else, but, the debt around here... I don't know if it's a great idea. I might just not do that. So, I don't know. Back and forth on it, but single dad life, you know, it's like dads don't drop their kids off with other dads. It's not a thing we do. We just kind of deal with it. You know? It's not easy squeezy. You know, finding stuff in between childcare is like... Like, if you have, like, a daycare center or something like that, it's like, it costs as much as your paycheck. Hey, Gold. How's it going? How you doing? Yeah, the legends were true. Yep, I'm back. Doing stuff. Basically, finished up with, Kana today. Not finished the game. We're still playing it, but... Yeah, basically finished for tonight because it's like 3:30 in the morning. No, it's 4 in the morning now. That's good. Yeah, because it's 4 in the morning. But yeah, I want to play more of this. But tomorrow will probably be Tunic. I don't know if you ever played that. It's like very heavily inspired by Zelda, but... also a lot like what's that Dwarves game with the Raven or whatever. Yeah, tumbly sort of fighting indie game. Yeah, playing Kena Among Us at 3 a.m. I'm about to make a 3 a.m. hamburger. Because I, for some reason, I'm just hungry, so I think I'm gonna... I'll use this as an excuse to do the dishes that I've been putting off. And, make a hamburger. An egg hamburger at 3 a.m. Yeah, if I care to at all, I probably won't, but... We'll snap a picture of it on the old Obama phone Pro Max HD 5G. First. Yes. Definitely first. No doubt about it. Was 100% Obama phone. Yeah. Obama phone Pro 5G Max. Now, I use a wall fart phone, but I just always liked the term Obama phone. I don't know why. I just thought it was hilarious. People first started calling them Obama phones, and then you think about an upgraded one. The Obama Plus. The Obama 5G. HD, 8 gig RAM, Fortnite included, pre-installed. Yeah, I'll just complete that first for you. You can have that. This aged like milk. All of these aged like milk, but this one in particular. Do you think that's why they deleted that YouTube Rewind? It was because of the slap heard around the world. Because they dealt with the dislikes and they never deleted it, and then that happens. Kind of curious. I heard they deleted it. I don't know that that's a fact, but that's what I heard. Yeah, that meme's dead in the water. Well, most of them are pretty gross. Most of these are stinky. Yeah, I gotta go through these and add some like newer stuff. God, Do It is even older than that, I think. Shia LaBeouf's. I'm sure the Obama phone could run Fortnite at 1080p by now. I'd think that they would have it under control. Yeah, I gave all the excuses and stuff like that. I was in a rough place. That's been the apology videos lately. I don't think any of them understand the etiquette behind apology videos now. And after how many parodied videos of people like saying this is how you do an apology video, they still haven't got it right. Yeah, Chris Rock is killing it because of that. I swear, like, I would have thought, like, his career was pretty close to done, you know? Like, I hadn't seen him in anything that I cared for in a long time. But, yeah, I brought him back. Huge come up right there, getting slapped in the face. at least he rolled with it, yeah. He made it work. That's awesome. Anyways, I guess I'm going to make this burger. I've been talking about it for like the last hour. I've also been out of water for like the last hour and a half, so it's like a good plan. And I'll be back on tomorrow late at night, early for you, probably afternoon for you, you know, noon for you, if I had to guess, noon, 1 o'clock, something like that. Yeah, and it's usually when it would happen. One of these times, I plan on... It's questionable. I don't know if I should do this, but it's like I plan on doing a Minecraft omelet thing to stir some stuff up again. To get all the craziness going. I don't know who's on there right now though, so I might have to do a little bit of scouting first and see what's going on there before I make the plunge. But yeah, it could be absolutely haywire in there and I have no idea. But yeah, I mean, from a glance it seems still about the same as it always has been, you know, for the most part. Other than the ads and the stuff that Omelette's doing. But as far as the people, it feels mostly the same, I think. I've, like, popped in, like, on occasion every now and then. But it's been a few months since I've looked. Anyway. Oh, crap. And I still gotta fix my aunt's still playing a stream on Omelette. Probably for that one. The Minecraft Connect thing. I'll probably stream on Omelette for that, because sometimes people talk in the chat of Omelette, and if I'm not streaming to it, I won't look at it, and then they'll just be talking into the void. I don't know. I think that's the best way to do it. To stir up stuff. To garner some attention. And bring it to Twitch or something. Yeah. Omelette's been on a steady decline for quite some time. It was pretty awesome there for quite a while. I don't know what's going on with it anymore. I used to talk to Nico a little bit here and there and have an idea of what they were planning and what they were going to do. Now, I think it's just radio silence. I haven't paid attention, so it's Nico's like the how would I describe it? He's the ambassador for the US side of Omelette Arcade. There's like different people that run different sections, like different pages. Like they have like the Omelette Espanol and stuff like that, and then different people handle that and talk to the people. But Nico was always the one that, you know, I would talk to about stuff. I think like I was yeah, I think it was easier to talk to me than most of the other people. And then like I would usually end up explaining to other people what was going on, because like a lot of people come to him and like kind of freak out about like any glitch or something like that, and I would explain it. You know, he seems to have like a awkward social tendency, which I do as well in real life, but online it's not really a thing for me as much as it seems to be for him. Never went that deep. It only got that deep when people asked me to become verified, and then that's when I kind of got involved with those people a little bit. The Hachiman community. I don't think I went into them. Who's that guy that made like a... It was Doge something. Oh, Doggy Dope Blaze. The guy who made a... like a Merrick Juniper group on Omelette. Oh, I remember Hachi. Okay, yes. Yeah, I do remember that person. Did they disappear now too? Are they gone? Pretty much everybody fled. Everybody went on to different things. There was Ducky. Ducky was still streaming on Omelette, I think, last I saw. He's on TikTok now. And then there was Dropper, who would like, I don't know, he had me fix a map for him at one point. Oh yeah, streaming on TikTok, that's an idea. I'd need to get a stream key though. I can do it. I have over 1,000 followers on there. I would need a, I think you have to email them for a stream key or something like that. So I would have to do that, I guess. But that'd be worth doing. I don't know. I don't know what I want to do quite yet. I know Twitch has like the exclusivity agreement junk. So there's a question of whether, like, you know, I might just want to, you know, branch to the tube and all the other stuff all at the same time, because they would allow me to do it all at the same time as opposed to being on here. It would suck losing the it would suck losing all like the channel point redeem things. That was like the main thing that I really enjoyed about. That was like the whole reason, that and the quality options was the main reason I chose to do the affiliate thing, but I probably shouldn't have done it. Yeah, this is the second day. I streamed 2 days ago. Just a little Hat in Time, because I couldn't decide what to play. And then I decided to go through my Epic Games list and my Steam list and GOG list, and I was like, man, all of these games that are just sitting here, I should just pick one, some of these that I've wanted to play for a long time. Now Tunic I've played, but I haven't played the new game plus, and I didn't play it fully. I beat the boss too early, so that's my fault. So I'll probably replay that and actually do it right, or the way you're supposed to, I guess. I don't know. you can do it any way you want, but I want to know what the rest of the items are. I want to solve all the puzzles. Yeah, Miss Wasab. I'm happy she's taking care of her. So, that's what I was told last, at least. I haven't heard anything after that, so. But yeah. That's good. She'll come back. She'll surprise us one day. She'll just pop in and be like, what in the... Where have you been? She'll probably forget all of her account information again and have to remake a new one, and we just won't know who she is for a long time. Yeah, she'll pop up out of nowhere for... You know, if we both got on Minecraft, I don't know if she'd be able to see it. I don't know what she's online with anymore, if she even looks at the games. But I know, like, maybe if the Microsoft account popped up with both of us playing some Minecraft, yeah, that might do it. That might be the beckoning call. The Warden. I still haven't killed the Warden. Still haven't done anything with the Warden. Stuck on a corporate job. Oh, God. I remember being in a cubicle. I did not want to do anything involving computers after I left or when I did that, so... That would suck. Anyways. Yeah. I'm gonna make this burger. I think. Don't want to be in a cubicle after calls. No. I think that's what... Like, I never had a panic attack up until that point in my life when I was working in a cubicle. I was riding a bus to work every day. I was working in a cubicle, and then I would ride the bus home, and then I would come sit in my house, and all day I'm just in a box all day long, and I was just talking to someone on the phone about, basically what I did was I handled subscriptions for a newspaper in Ohio. And I was talking to this person about their subscription plan, and out of nowhere, for no reason, completely good conversation, just, you know, like tunnel vision and numbing of the face. And I'm like, dude, am I going to throw up? Where am I going to throw up? Are people going to think I'm on drugs or something, or drinking on the job if I throw up right now? I just, like, all these thoughts are going through my head, and I'm like, panicking. And I'd never had a panic attack before that, so it really hit me. Like, I thought I was dying or something. And then it didn't hit again until I got on the bus. And it didn't hit until the bus doors closed. And then all of a sudden, like, the face numb came back. Yeah, it's probably stress, but... But when the door closed on the bus, what I realized it was, I think, mostly was, like, being confined. Like, just being stuck in a place. Not being able to pee when I need to, not being able to take a drink or eat or whatever when I needed to. I don't know. I think something about that manifested due to me just constantly being in a spot, in a box. Doing nothing, like, basically. Entrepreneur class. Man, so they actually make you do work in entrepreneur class? I always heard that was like a blow-off thing. Like, go to entrepreneur class and just chill and talk about potential business startup ideas or something. Digital animation. Yeah, I would much rather like to do something remotely from home. That would be comfortable. That would be nice. I could rock in my chair and panic and still get work done. I guess you're in the Philippines. Yeah. Most recently, it's just been like grunt work mostly, like getting stuff ready, construction. A whole lot of nothing big on this end right now. So that, yeah, that's why I was thinking about for education somewhere. So I have a sheet of paper that, because like they say like with coding or programming, whatever, you don't necessarily need a degree or whatever, but it helps, especially if you're in the middle of nowhere and you need to show someone that you have the credentials you need to pull off something, you know? I'm working out as lots of studies just yet. Yeah, a simple walk is nice. But yeah, I do. I usually ride a bike or something, but sometimes I don't have the time in the day, so. So yeah, maybe I'll do some sick ab crunches on the inversion table or something that's sitting over there. But it does help, you know, releasing some endorphins and not drinking too much caffeine is a good way to, that helps a lot. Just having a cup in the morning. I realized that I was pounding energy drinks when I started having those panic attacks too, so that was definitely a part of it, because I was going to work for like 8 to 10 hours, and then I would come home and I would stream for like 12 hours, and yeah, I was up until like 3 or 4 in the morning, and then I would get up at 7 or 8 in the morning and do it all over again. I maybe like 4 hours of sleep every day. Yeah, energy drinks are bad. The one I was drinking wasn't too terrible. It was like a rock star with, it had like 120 milligrams of caffeine and no carbonation. It was like an orange one. It was really good, but I haven't had that in years now. It tasted like Tang. Red Tang. The poor man's orange juice. It's good stuff. I actually like it a lot. I should get some Tang if I can find it anywhere. That'd be nice. A nice nostalgia drink. I went to a trade school for electronics, and you know, I got my soldering certificate, and it was like manufacturing electronics, not exactly programming or anything like that. No software, like learning resistors, coding, and Ohm's law and all that junk. The cubicle was just a job working for dealing with subscribers to a newspaper in Ohio. It was just like a job to have. That's the thing, like a lot of people will tell you they go to school for one thing and they end up doing things completely different. Like I never went to school for nursing or anything like that, but I've done independent home care and worked for CRI, took care of a quadriplegic and a paraplegic on the weekends. And that was like my first job, and I had that for like 4 years. And You know, and I was line cook and then eventually kitchen specialist at one place at a diner. Just because I'm in a rural area, there's not a lot like electronics wise that I could do. And things have only really blown up in a big way, as far as electronics go, like within like the last 10 years, like things have changed entirely. You know, like the radio that I was building in electronics class pales in comparison to the iPhone that people have in their pocket now, you know, so. Basically, yeah. Essentially what it was. Well, yeah, I mean, things have changed. So I thought about, you know, just doing another thing. Same thing, kind of. Still electronics, just programming, just diving deeper, which I already have a basic understanding of. It would just help expand upon that. And it's something I could do remotely. It's something I could find a job for that I, you know, around, you know, in the woods that I wouldn't have to leave, wouldn't have to find something or move to a city. The city's all right, but there are moments, and then there are really bad moments in the city. There was a, yeah, I'm not sure if I ever told this story on stream, but it was I was working for this factory line basically, and I was in a city, and it was in a boarding house. And there were, it was basically like a frat house. Like we were, you know, having a great time every day. You know, there was this guy who was off of the army for PTSD. He bought beers like every night, and everyone was drinking all the time. And then there was this other guy who was about to go to the army. And there was this guy who was a bit socially inept. Both of them were named Joe, so we called the one going to the army GI Joe and the other one Cowboy Joe because he was from the sticks as well. And Cowboy Joe got deep into well, first it was weed and then it was like psychedelics and then yeah, and then he just stopped paying attention to his school and his parents or whoever it was stopped paying for his rent at the boarding house, which was only like $50 a week, which is why I stayed there because I was always working. Yeah, he tripped hard and he lost focus. That was basically it. And GI Joe was making rent by selling weed to Cowboy Joe for the most part. And eventually GI Joe found these people on the street that were like, oh yeah, we're looking for some bud or something. And he brought them into our boarding house. And I was in a different city for this weekend. So he had to tell me the story when I came back. He invited these guys up to his room and he gave them their bag. And they were like, oh yeah, this stuff smells great. Can I see the big bag? And he ended up giving them the big bag to see. And I was like, dude, why'd you do that? They just ran. They took it, and yeah, I knew right away. Yeah, they're gone. You just gave them your money. So he didn't make it, and it was like Survivor, basically. Like, yeah, he just handed it to them because they said they wanted to smell it or something. Yeah, and they were gone instantly. Yeah, I guess they were both socially inept, and. Yeah, and the guy with PTSD was driving Cowboy Joe's car one night and wrecked it. And the cops were banging on my door at 2 in the morning, and they were like, "Hey, do you know who lives here? Because his car is now at the impound lot, and we don't know who was driving it." And I was like, "Oh yeah, that's Joe. I don't really know him that well. I did, but I said I didn't, you know." Went back to bed because I was tired. I was ready for bed. I wanted to get up in the morning. The states are crazy. Yeah, the cities are wild. You know, the rural areas aren't much better, but there's a lot of corruption as far as like the system itself. You know, because not enough people, they're not making money off of like real crime and stuff like that. So people get like picked up for petty things and stuff like that. It's a whole other ball game, but it's harder in the city, I think, you know, to a certain degree. But yeah, that was basically it until I was like the last guy left in this boarding house in the city, and then this older guy moved in and I left him G.I. Joe's beers that he left behind, and he was like, hey, do you smoke? And I was like, sometimes. And he was like, hey, come on in, come here. And he loaded up a pipe with crack in it. And I was like, oh, I don't smoke this. And I left. I moved out that weekend. I got my paycheck and I left. I was gone. I was like, nope, this is not the same house it was. No one's cool anymore. I'm gone. Yeah, crack pipe. I was like, dude, this guy's gonna end up stealing from me for some crack one of these days or something. I'm out of here. Yeah. And I basically just stayed in the boarding house because I was always working anyway. So just having a room for $50 a week was fine with me. It was just something to get by with. But yeah, the city can be wild. If depending on where you are, I guess. Yeah. But I guess it's the States as well. I mean, it's the States. It's crazy. It's all nuts all the time. Yeah. Yeah, here in this area, like, we have one road that they changed from a one-way in one direction to a one-way in the other direction for no inherent reason. They didn't put up a sign or anything. They just stuck a squad car there and charged people for $150 a pop because they're not making money from real crime. So, like, they gotta, you know, cheat people out of money somehow. So the same people, like, you know, same people who've been turning the same way for the last 30 or so years, just getting, you know, blatantly extorted, basically. And that's basically country life, you know. You're always getting screwed over by somebody, potentially. No, no, city life can be okay. You know, any life can be okay. It's just, yeah, there's certain places, you know, that can be better than others, that's all. And some can be exactly the same as every other one. I don't know. I mean, I'm in PA, which you don't want to be in. This place sucks. You know, the second I can get out, I plan on it. Just, it's like, where to, you know, where go? Where go now? What do? Because, yeah. Because this place, this, you know, it's bad. Like, the meth in this state is bad. You can't find, you know, a decent person to be with or anything like that, because they're all just strung out. It's bad. It's terrible. I want someone strung out on video games. It's not here. Not here. Getting ready for the day. Yeah, it's hard keeping motivated, especially when you're doing the same thing every day. I definitely get that for sure. Even when everything's like together and not necessarily bad, or like you have minor stresses, sure, but you know, basically things that are figured out, You know, and still it can be a drag. It's just hard to, you got to find little things throughout the day to kind of keep yourself going. Little new things like maybe, I don't know, try a new food, new restaurant, something like that. Switch it up, keep it fresh, you know. Because keeping the rest of your day fresh will at least allow you to keep your mindset somewhat decent on doing the same crap with the rest of your day, you know. Yeah. That doesn't always work. I mean, you can't always do that. Sometimes you just gotta come home because you're broke and it sucks, but I've lived those days. Tuna fish. Like, I probably have had mercury poisoning at some point because I ate so much tuna at one point. Like, MRE packets because they're like low calorie but high protein. Like, I would just crush like six crackers in the tuna packet. That'd be lunch. I'd eat oatmeal for breakfast. I basically had like 300 calories until dinner for the entire day at best. The struggle days, definitely done it. Yeah, so you gotta kind of find something else outside of that. Anything else? It's hard to say. Working out though, like you said, that's a good one. That'll get the endorphins flowing and at least allow your mind to chemically alter itself, which helps. Andrew Tate stuff. I don't know what's going on with him right now. I've been out of the loop ever since he lost his limelight, kind of. I don't know. I always like saw him shilling his Be a Better Man class courses kind of thing. And maybe some people need that. Maybe they need it pounded into their head, to which is okay. That's fine. A lot of the stuff that he said is true. Some of it is crazy. You know, like there's a lot of it that he says that we've already thought, though. That's the thing. Like, he's like, yeah, you're in the Matrix. You're being ruled by elites and stuff. Yeah, we know. We know, man. Maybe some people didn't know, and that's how he got so famous. Some people were surprised. I guess some people got shocked. Wow, really? There's people. You serious? They're in my phone? Yes. Yes. Yes, they are. We know. We've known for years. Yeah. If anyone, you should be holding Edward Snowden on a pedestal or something, you know. One of the first guys to expose it, you know, or Assange or something, you know, not whatever, you know. Things Tate saying shit. Yeah, he's just. Oh, well, now, like, I have heard something recently, like him, like, putting shitty poetry on Twitter or something like that. And, like, yeah, if that's what it is now, then yeah, I really don't understand. His brotherly advices. Yeah, like I said, he says some true things. There's some nuggets in there, and it's okay if some people need it pounded into their head to get out there and do something. You know, that's okay. I guess I can understand. But there's a lot of other options, is the thing, you know. What's his face? What's his face? Jordan Shanks. He has like a self-help channel thing that he's been trying to do. I'd probably just watch him if I needed it. Or yeah, a little friendly Geordies or something. Someone with a bit more positive a demeanor. I don't think I could handle a negativity to that ca of that caliber all day long. It would burn you out pretty hard, I bet. You know, if you constantly looked at it as like a combative thing rather than a self-improvement sort of thing. I don't know though. I don't really know. I'm out of the loop. Like I said, I'm out of it. And it's also 4:30 in the morning, so I'm even more out of it than I would be during the day. But anyway, it's been good chilling and chatting with you. I guess I'm gonna make burgers and I'm gonna get some more water because my mouth is extremely dry. And I'll be back on tomorrow with some tunic, I think. Tunic will be good. My social media pages are filled with motivational bodybuilding videos. Yeah. Yeah. Ripped. I don't really like bodybuild or work out, like go out to the gym or anything like that. I just constantly, like any excuse that I can find to get up and do something, I do it. You know, like it's a good mindset to put yourself in to, you know, I get to do this. Like, I get to ride a bike today and smell the fresh air and feel the breeze on my face, and it's just nice, you know. Nothing bad about that. Lost like 15 kilograms, feel great, yeah. Light as a feather. Yeah, there's always room for more improvement. Keep in mind moderation, though, you know. It's okay to have a greasy burg every now and then. There was that one guy who worked out like all the time and always ate healthy, and then like he had like a week where he smoked cigarettes and ate burgers and he just died. So, moderation, you know. Yeah. Bro fell off. Yeah. His body was not even equipped to handle anything outside of the norm. Yeah. So it's okay to build up a bit of immunity to some terrible things, but only in small doses, you know. When you take poison, you don't, you know, you don't shovel it in your mouth, you take a tiny bit. Improve quality, build probably didn't beat his deadlift. Yeah, protein. Yeah, protein. Tuna. I used to do the creatine thing. I don't really now, like I did like in, you know, my early 20s. That was the thing. I had one creatine that was so good, like my arm, my forearm, I would just see a quiver in it, like just going off for no reason. And that was kind of scary, to be honest. And I had one creatine that did nothing, just complete garbage. Of course, it has to saturate and stuff like that, but yeah. But yeah, I mean, that was just me like saying I've had creatines that have had different consistencies. Definitely try not to go with any sort of proprietary blends or anything like that that people make of like protein drinks or creatines or anything like that. 'Cause like then they can just shovel whatever dog crap they want to into it. Like basically the $10 a tub things are usually not great. They probably work with enough of it, but yeah. Yeah, you gotta have days for legs and days for arms. A lot of people do like everything like all day. Like just they'll do both legs and arms and they won't see any build. They'll get stronger, but they won't see like any real build of any kind. You still want to draw, yeah. There's probably a way to factor both of those in if you wanted to. It could always be on the bike, just drawing it up, you know. Yeah, can you pull off your smooth lines while you're riding over gravel or something? Or, you know, take a canvas. Take your own boxing glove and, like, splatter it with paint. You know, just splatter paint all over a canvas with boxing gloves. My workout regimen, I call it. I call this one a cramp. Yeah, I probably would. That would be the most expensive art. Like, you could advertise it as a, you know, physical expression. And people would be intrigued. Just so intrigued by it. Yeah, I'm about to make a protein burger, though. I'm not adding protein or anything to it. Oh, I recently got this stuff called PB Fit, which is pretty good. It's all right. It's not peanut butter by any means, but it's a... protein burger. It's just a burger, like an Angus quarter pound burger with an egg on it. Crack an egg on it. Yeah. So, that's all that is. But yeah, PB Fit, it's like a powdered peanut butter, and you can, you mix it with water to make peanut butter, and it basically has the protein and stuff like that, but without the unhealthy fats or sugars. Yeah, some steak and protein powder. Now that's thinking. You want to build? We're going to get a Delmonico. I'm going to make milk steak. I'm going to crack a couple crow's eggs on it. Yeah. And start cutting it up. Sticking the fork in your mouth. No, what are you doing? I'm eating the milk steak, man. No. That's how we do it. Just smoked the milk steak. Oh god. I've been up too late. That's ridiculous. Snort the milk steak and I drink the crow's eggs. I lift the dumbbell. Yeah, this thing is basically, it hangs me upside down so that my spine can reverse its pressure, and sometimes I'll do some crunches on it. Yeah, I'm sort of the steak. Just barrel your chest out and, you know, and the steak will just absorb into you. Yeah. No, I'm just hungry, so I wanted a burger. So I was feeling egg, cheddar, Angus burger with some chipotle mayo on it. It's gonna be good. It's gonna be the way to go out tonight. It's how I'm gonna convince myself to do the dishes. Because I'll have to wash the frying pan. Yeah, white cheddar sounds good. God, I can't wait to go shopping. I'm getting pretty close. I'm getting close. I'm cutting it. I got food, but it's like mostly carbs, like spaghetti, pancakes, and there's tuna. There's tuna in there. There's oatmeal. There's Bergs, obviously. Bergs and fries and stuff. Yeah, I just need more. Need more stuff. More variety, because that's about it, really. Crackers. Yeah, I'd be willing to try it. You have to send me a recipe, or I'll look it up. If I can remember. at 5 in the morning. But yeah, I do like cheese. I do like cheese. I don't like Polish cheese pierogies, apparently. Because I had a friend who had a girlfriend who had a father who made us his famous cheese pierogies, he called it. And I was picturing mashed potatoes in a pierogi with some cheese. It was just cheese in a pierogi, no mashed potatoes or anything. And it, dude, I didn't shit for 2 days. I was a teenager. I was too young to not shit for 2 days because of cheese. Dear God. What did this guy do to those pierogies? All right. All right. It's been good. It's been good chatting. Yeah, I don't understand the rotten cheese. No, I don't understand blue cheese. I don't understand cottage cheese even. And that's just like not fully done cheese. I don't get that either. Yeah. Give me a brick. Yeah, a halfway cheese. I just want a brick of pepper jack to chew on like a dog toy. I'll be happy. A brick of pepper jack or Swiss. There's like a smoked woody tasting Swiss at this one deli I used to go to. It was so good. I would just put that stuff in soup. It'd be amazing. I want to make a good soup here soon. As soon as we get to go to the... I get paid on the 6th. Dang it. Yeah, it's been good. I gotta go do stuff as well. I gotta wash dishes and make a burg. Yeah, you as well. Have a good evening. I'll see you today. Maybe. Tomorrow. Something. What day is it? Yes. Well, let's see you then. Take it easy.